Oh, there they are.
Where?
Don't cast on top of them, whatever you do, bro. They're on the other side of the rig right here. They're on the top. There's about four or five of them.
All right, what's going on right now is we're out here cobia fishing with Captain Ryan Folse. Got a rough day right after the hurricane came through. We've been to five or six rigs, nothing. Just spotted four cobia on this platform. They've been spooky. Ryan's gonna put on a live bait, getting everything rigged, and we're gonna go back and see if we can find them. They are either gonna be up or they're not, but there's some fish on this rig, and we'll see what we can do. Yesterday, boats were out here all day, caught six fish. We see four of them right now, so things may be changing. LOA TV is brought to you by Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser and LouisianaTravel.com. Come to Louisiana, where you catch fish.
Oh, there they are. There they are, right off the corner.
Yeah. There you go, you got him, huh?
Got one.
Here, let me see if I can get one. Come up with him.
Yeah, that's friends with him. This is a small one, it looked like, but he's on it. Oh, spit it out. Oh, there he is, look, he's chasing the bait. Look at him. Oh, there's a couple bigger ones. I'm trying not to catch the little one. The little one's hungry. There you go, Kevin.
I got a little one, damn it. All right, he got off, good. That one's too small, right? Is that a keeper?
Yeah, that's a keeper right there, okay. Sure. I got one. Oh, spit it out again. There you go. That's a good keeper.
I got a keeper here.
Nice, he's friends, he has friends.
Yep. Woo-hoo! Son of a gun. That sucker hit it. Here he comes. It'll be like a tarpon.
Good job.
Come on, buddy.
Where's his friends at? He's got another good one with him, a nice cobia.
Oh, that's a pretty fish.
Yes, he is.
That's a beautiful fish.
Oh, look, his buddy's right behind him.
Beautiful cobia here. I mean, not the biggest one in the world, but look how pretty that is with that rockport rattler jig.
Got him. Hey, there's some more swimming. They got some more swimming underneath this one, too. Oh, he spit it out. You gotta be kidding me.
All right, let's see if we can get this fish in. There's one with this. They're all with him. They're with mine right here. I think once we get the gap, we're good. It's fun to catch these things.
Yeah,
there's mine.
Fun. That's a pretty cobia, Kevin.
Yep.
I don't know where his buddies went.
Well, we'll go back to the rig and find him in a little while. That's the thing about cobia. You're normally going to see more than one. There he is.
Kevin's getting worn out.
This one is, he's fighting me good. Here he comes again.
All right.
All right, now you get the hell out of the way. Woo, yes.
All right.
Awesome. The reason why you get out the way of these things is because of those spines on top. They will get you. But that is a beautiful cobia.
Yes, sir.
To start the morning. And that's what we catch in the morning. That jig right there. It's got the rattle chamber in it, and it works. Whew. Got me worn out. That was fun. Very fun, as a matter of fact. And when
you get
in October, this is what happens. And folks, we were at 10 rigs, nothing. And we stopped for 5 minutes, and that's what you have to do. When they're not jumping in the boat, you don't see them at every rig. I mean, you make a couple of drops with live bait or dead bait, a couple of casts with the jig, and if you don't get them up, then move on to the next one. Because normally, like that rig right there, has got 15 or 20. We're gonna go back and see if we can get any more. They still may be coming up over there.
Hopefully so.
And
LOATV is brought to you by Soft Science Supreme Comfort Footwear, the most comfortable footwear you will ever wear.
I just saw at least four more, at least. See, they're swimming around the platform. Now, they just showed up by this leg right out there. You see them out there?
I think so.
Look about 8 foot past the platform. Oh, they turned, went back the other way.
Yeah, I see.
Position the boat and get where we could actually catch them. The current's pulling real hard this way. And if we hook them on this side, then this fish is gonna wanna pull us into the platform. So before we hook one, we wanna make sure that we're in a good spot to drift away. So I'm Kevin. Look, Kevin, they're swimming this way.
Where?
They're swimming to your right. They're swimming to your right. Throw to the right, way past them.
There?
Oh, that should be a cobia. Start reeling in real fast. They're coming right at us.
I see them. Right there. That's a nice one right there.
Here he comes. Here he comes.
There he comes.
Got him.
You got yours?
Yes, sir. Right, oh, they got some more big ones. Look, swimming all over.
Where?
Right here by mine.
Okay, hold on. I'm going to get him. Oh, yeah, you got a good one, huh?
Yes, sir.
There's one.
There you go. Oh, look, there's a
yeah!
guy.
Oh, yeah, double. How about that, boys?
That was sweet.
Was that sweet or what? Oh, man.
Let's see if we can do this without getting all tangled up here, Kevin.
Yeah.
That's a nice size cobia right here.
All
right,
you want to go this way?
I'm coming under you.
Oh, mine got off.
Did he really?
Yeah. That's a pretty one. You want me to hold the line for you and you can gaff him?
That'll work with me. Let me wear him out for you. I wouldn't want to break your back again.
Yeah.
This sucker's pulling.
You don't see the other ones, do you?
I don't.
That was a big one I had on.
Boy, it was. I wonder if that was the same one you had hooked or if it was another one. That was a good little pile of them.
They're still there.
We had a double hookup, which is good.
Yeah, there's the little one with him right there.
Yep.
All right, here, crap.
You want to finish him up?
Yeah, I'm going to finish him up so Ryan can get the gaff on the fish. Ooh. See the little one with him, y'all? A little baby went with him. The big one went away.
All right, let me get behind you right here. That way I don't swing them on you like I did earlier.
Yeah. All right.
Try to turn them this way real quick. There we go. Oh, no way, no way.
All right. There we go. Woo! Number two. That's how cobia fishing is. Nothing, 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 and then just pure excitement. Crazy. All the rigs we went to, we didn't think we were gonna catch a fish today. We're gonna go right back to this platform again, and I bet you these fish are gonna be up and we're gonna go find them again. Because Ryan, we can catch a bunch of fish off of one platform, can't we?
Yes, sir, right there, especially when they're swimming around. We have a couple of them following us, but some of them are still staying, so it's a good thing. We're gonna go right back to it and hope and pray for the best.
You crazy. Picking that fish up like that, you're braver than me.
Cobia.
What's that noise?
He's getting me all bloody. Yeah, they pretty mean fish.
You're always gonna have to replace these tails. These are 8-inch curly tails. Normally, chartreuse is the best color. But what I like to do sometimes is bite a couple of inches off. If you can get 6 inches, you bite a couple of inches off that tail and then just rig it up like this. And let me show you what happens. What happens is you've got that curly part right next to the hook. And that seems to be a little bit more effective. So you can take the 8-inch ones, get 6 inches if you can, take the 8-inch ones, cut it a couple of inches off, and that tail is right next to that hook, and they seem to like that a little better. There he is! That's not a cobia, though. Yeah, it is. Small one. See if we can get something come up with him. But it is a cobia. So let's just let him, we just got
there's
off.
There's one behind it. Another little one.
You can only keep two of these per person. You can easily release the small ones. Just getting one on the line and getting some to come up, that's the key.
LOATV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer.
Oh, come on. This one just hit very quickly. Let's see if he's got a friend. We move to another rig.
Fighting like a big old red snapper.
Oh, there's a cobia, big cobia right side of me.
Oh, a whole bunch of them.
Whole bunch of them. See the red snapper come up. When you get these red snapper to come up like this, look at the cobia. Oh God, that's a good cobia.
There we go. Come get it. This one, Kevin. Put that one in the rod holder.
All right, put this one in the rod holder.
I got the big one. Let's go. Hold this.
Hold on.
Hold this rod. I swear I'll hook him.
All right. We're gonna keep this fish in the water just because. But we got a bunch of cobia that are down below us. Now, we caught a little, earlier today, we caught a white trout.
All right, got another big one.
You got a big one?
Yeah, the biggest one, or the biggest one swimming around. Wow!
On a white trout.
Oh, golly!
See, this is amazing. They'll hit. Now look, there's another big one swimming around my bait right now over here. Now he just took your bait. He just ate it, didn't he?
I'm letting him swallow it this time.
You got him?
He spit it out again.
Well, that one ate it.
All right. All right, golly, they making it hard on us here.
Now there goes mine over here. Mine's just been sitting out here forever as we're trying to hook up another one. We've got like 30 of them out here.
Awesome. Let's
all right.
Let me get this rod out the way.
But look at all these cobia. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna stay here and be quiet. Once I get this, if we can gaff this fish here, mine, okay? If we can gaff this one and get the jig out of him, look at yours.
Tarpon.
Oh, think this is fun?
This
every
is awesome.
Fall. There's mine. He's coming. And I'm gonna get to the front of you because, wait, what side do I wanna get of you?
You good, right there.
Okay. All right.
You are on the right side.
Now we're gonna leave that other fish on the hook. All right. Here we go. A cobia. And a lemon fish. All right, that's Ryan's fish right here that he caught. So I'm gonna let Ryan put this fish in the net because we're not quite sure he's a keeper. That yellow rig back there is where all of this started. And these cobia have followed us this far. That's what it means to have a cobia hooked on the line. They will follow you. So we're gonna go back to that rig, but this current is running so far, that's almost 3/4 of a mile. I mean, we're moving. I can't tell how many knots we're moving, but we're moving 2 or 3 knots right now. So we're gonna get this fish in a second, I think.
Yeah, 1 second. I'm just gonna throw this bait out there.
And see what happens.
Yeah, but we're gonna net him. And those big cobia are just right out there and they've been eating the chum. So now we throw a little piece of chum out there and we'll go wait and see.
All right, so, but that's a pretty fish right there.
Yes, he is.
We'll see if he's...
Just real careful, Kev. When I net him, he's going to go crazy.
I don't think he can go too crazy.
No, he's been fighting a good little while against all that current. You're right.
Now, you got to measure him, because what's he got to be?
Yeah, he's a keeper.
Yeah, he is a keeper.
I'm not going to beat him in the head quite yet, though. I'll show you how the forward flipper works if he settles down. Look at that, he's eating some shells or something.
I didn't create the forward flipper for a...
There you go.
That's pretty good. Yeah, I may have just sold some for Christmas. Well, this is how it's done.
Good work.
It's crazy. It's unbelievable. And now here's the scary part. We're gonna go back to the rig.
Okay. Do it all over again.
Do it all over again. But it's Joey's turn. So I'm gonna be holding the camera.
Awesome.
No, that's really scary.
That's not scary, huh?
So what we need to do probably is take a break at this point, and you may need to go take some Dramamine, get your seasick pills, because Kay Ford's gonna be holding the camera when we come back on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
LOA TV is brought to you by Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser and LouisianaTravel.com. Come to Louisiana, where you catch fish. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Book your adventure today.
All right, we're going to head back to that rig now and see if we can get them to come up again. But remember how we caught that fish. We tell you that when they're on the bottom, when these cobia are on the bottom, if you hook something, they'll come up. It wasn't a cobia that came up. It was a red snapper that we caught. And that brought the cobia up. So sometimes if you catch a snapper, let him swim and those cobia will come up. And that's why we saw 15 or 20 of them, not because we hooked a cobia, but because we hooked a snapper, which of course we released because they're rare and elusive here in the Gulf of Mexico. And I'm being facetious. So back to the rig we go.
Oh, there they are. They on this one. They on this one. Let's get the one free line with just the hook. See them?
Oh yeah, I see them.
Whole bunch of them.
Whole bunch of them. Free line with the hook.
Here it is right here. We just need to hook a sardine through the eyes right here.
You want a live trout or not?
Just a sardine through the eyes.
Here. Oh my look. God, look at them all.
They're gonna come to us. Joey, cast on them, cast on them.
God, you're gonna wet that. Dude, Joey, what do I do with this camera? How do I hit record? Press the red button?
Well, if you remember before the last break, I said it was going to be dangerous with me holding the camera. The red button was already pushed. I pushed it again, so I put it on pause. So everything I'm shooting right now is not being shot. But as you can see, Joey Bordelon has got a cobia on. There's a bunch of them swimming around his line. This is the most we've seen all day, as a matter of fact. Ryan's on the back of the boat. He's about to hook one himself. Again, when we talk about these cobia, some interesting facts. The limit is 2 per person, and they have to be 33 inches forklift, which is the distance from the mouth of the cobia to the middle of the forked tail. So that's how you measure a cobia. And we're catching these fish in the fall, and these are very migratory fish. About 80% of them migrate in the spring from South Florida to as far away as the Texas Gulf Coast and all the way up the Atlantic seaboard. And then in the fall, where we are now, they go back from Texas and they start heading back to South Florida, where they're going to spend the winter. Now, some of these fish really go a long way. Interesting fact, they tag a lot of cobia. And one of the cobia they tagged went over 1,300 miles. It was tagged off the Chandelier Islands in Louisiana and was recaptured 1,046 days later off the coast of South Carolina. So really amazing to think about how they can travel. And they spawn in the summertime as well, and they're a very fast grower. These cobia we're catching right now are about 2 years old. They're 35 inches when they're about 2 years old, so they really, really grow fast. They like to eat fin fish. They're not very finicky, but boy, they're fun to catch, and they're one of the tastiest fish you're going to find in the Gulf of Mexico.
All right, so Joey's got one. We had a couple of them. We had a little problem with somebody doing something with the recorder that he wasn't supposed to do, and now that's a nice cobia right there. And what we did is we went to this platform and just saw them on the top. It was pretty awesome. These fish were right on top of the water. And when they're like that, Ryan, it's awesome, isn't it?
Oh, yes, sir, it is, man. We hit all these platforms and we're looking and looking. They it's kind of tough today for them. But whenever you see them like that on the surface, it's like opening up a nice Christmas gift on Christmas Day.
Yep.
Well, that's going to wrap it up for a great trip out of Cocodrie, Louisiana with Captain Ryan Folse of Coco Marina. And folks, when it comes to eating seafood, make sure you get Louisiana seafood, some of our great shrimp, our great crabs. Go to the website, louisianaseafood.com, to learn all about the best tasting seafood in the world. For producer Joey Bordelon, I'm Kevin Ford, and we'll see you next time for another edition of Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.